Hi, kindergarten. This week in math, we're going to talk all about fact families. Fact families are simply just seeing how numbers are related together in an addition and a subtraction sentence. So we're going to take a look at my fact family house here. You can see that inside my roof, I have three different numbers, 8, 10, and 2. I also have two blank addition sentences and two blank subtraction sentences. And the reason I know that this is an addition sentence is because it has the plus and the equal sign. And I know that this is a subtraction sentence because it has the minus and the equal sign. So before we get to see how this fact family works and how they're all related, I'm going to see what you already know about addition and subtraction. So you learned last week that we always use the plus and the equal sign in an addition sentence. We also are learning that an addition sentence is made up of two parts to get the whole, all right? The whole is known as the answer or the sum. So these two small parts that come before and after the plus sign are also known as addends. Those numbers, those two smaller parts that come before and after that plus sign are known as addends. And the answer, which comes after the equal sign, is known as the sum, or the whole, all right? And remember, in an addition sentence, that whole number is always gonna be the biggest number, all right? So remember that as we do those fact family stories together, remember that tip, that the whole number in an addition sentence is always gonna be the biggest number, okay? Because those two smaller parts make up the whole, all right? And you also wanna review with me subtraction. So let's talk about it, okay? We know in a subtraction sentence that you use the minus and the equal signs. Now, what's different about subtraction is that you start with the whole, okay? That biggest number is the whole, remember? And you take away a part from that whole to get another part. And remember, that answer after the equal sign in a subtraction sentence is known as the difference. So remember that the biggest number in a subtraction sentence is the whole, right? And that will always go first. Then you'll have your parts. All right, so from reviewing that, then let's see what we can do with our fact family, all right? So we remember when I showed you that little house inside the roof, we see that these three numbers are there, 8, 10, and 2. Now remember, we have to use only these numbers once, all right? But we have to use all of them to get two addition and two subtraction sentences. So let's look at our two addition sentences. Do you remember what I said is always going to be after the equal sign here? What comes after the equal sign? Is it the part or the whole in an addition story? It's going to be the whole, right? The whole number always comes last in an addition sentence. Do you remember what else I said about the whole? The whole number is going to be the biggest number. So let's look at all three numbers here. Which one is the biggest number? Is 8 the biggest number? No, I still see a number that's bigger than 8. Do you? You got it. 10. 10 is the biggest number. 2 is still less than 10, and 8 is also less than 10. So 10 is the biggest number. I'm going to put that biggest number, the whole number, after the equal sign. That's my sum. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now and show you. As we do this, now we can get closer to forming these addition sentences and seeing how these numbers are related. So then let's look at the next two numbers that we have. We use 10, so then we have these two numbers left. We have 8 and 2. Well, let's go ahead and plug those two numbers in like that, 8 and 2, all right? So we're gonna plug in 8 and 2. And in fact, that is a true statement. 8 plus 2 does equal 10. So that if we know 8 plus 2 equals 10, then what else do we know equals 10? We have to use these same numbers. I'll give you a clue. These two numbers can flip-flop. They can switch. So let's just flip-flop them. Let's put 2 first, and then let's put 8 here, okay? They're addends, remember, and addends can always flip-flop or switch. So here we go. 2 plus 8 equals 10. If we know that 8 plus 2 equals 10, then we also know that 2 plus 8 equals 10. Remember, we're using only these three numbers, but we're using them in a related way to show that we can make two addition sentences that are true. And these both are. Great job, guys. So now let's move down to our subtraction sentences. Remember what we said? In a subtraction sentence, the whole will always come first. The whole, or the biggest number, will always come first. So again, which number is the biggest? You got it. 10 is the biggest number. So I'm going to go ahead and write that number 10 first in both my subtraction sentences here. So here I go. I put 10 first because that's the whole. The whole we start with first in a subtraction sentence. So now we have to take away a part to get to another part. So let's look at those two numbers that are left. We have 8 and we have 2. So let's go ahead and plug those numbers in. We have 8 and we have 2. Now I'm going to check by reading left to right to see if that, in fact, that sentence is true. All right. 10 minus 8 equals 2. Now, if you weren't sure and you wanted to just double check, you could always get or make yourself a number line. Remember, you start at 10. And if I'm subtracting 8, that means I'm going to count back 8. So watch me count back 8. And they're saying, if I use those fact families, they're saying that 10 minus 8 equals 2. So if I count back 8 and get to 2 here, you'll know that it's right. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yep, it in fact is 2. I double checked on my number line. It's a true statement. So now I can move on to my last subtraction sentence. Boys and girls, if I know that 10 minus 8 equals 2, then what else do I know? I can't use 10 again. And I can't use 8 the same way. So what do I need to do? Let's switch them, right? Let's do 10 minus 2 equals 8. And that, in fact, is another true subtraction sentence. Great job, guys. So this is known as a fact family because all of these three numbers are related in a way to form addition and subtraction sentences. This week, what you're going to get at home is a little packet of fact families, okay? So you're going to work through these addition and subtraction sentences by looking at the roof. You're going to see those three related numbers, and you'll know that the whole number in an addition sentence is always the biggest number, but that comes last. That comes after the equal sign. But in a subtraction sentence, that whole number, that biggest number, will come first. So remember those clues. Have fun solving these fact families.